Channel 4 Studios in Boston. This is WBZ News at 6.
A nor'easter delivering a heavy blow tonight. Here's a live look at the scene in Scituate.
A little farther south, snowing pretty hard in Plymouth right now. And they've got a few more hours before it starts to wind down.
And Boston already with plenty of snow. Its biggest storm since our record winter 2 years ago. This is what Copley Square looks like right now. Good evening, everyone. I'm Katie Brace.
And I'm Ken McLeod. We're glad that you could go ahead and join us on this snowy Saturday. This storm's already created quite a mess in the Carolinas and across the south. Now it's unloading on us. We have live team coverage from Sandwich to Plymouth to Scituate and, of course, Boston. But we begin with Chief Meteorologist Eric Fisher.
All right, Ken, Katie, good evening to you and good evening, everybody. It has been a very snowy day across the area and our storm going according to plan so far. But we've seen some tremendous snowfall rates and it depends on where you live. Certainly the highest totals have been in the southeastern part of the state. Now you look to the west, you see where these darker blues are? They're kind of stretched up from the Hartford area up to about Worcester, anywhere north and west. Snow very light and dry air is in charge. That heavier snow is not moving any farther west, so you'll stay into the light stuff. In fact, the lighter rates will start to press eastward over the next couple of hours, but we still have some bands of very heavy snow that at times is coming down at more than an inch per hour. That strongest band right now is right over Scituate Harbor and stretching southwest into Brockton, Bridgewater, just off to the northwest side of Taunton. And we can look at some of the snowfall rates in here, 2 to 3 inches per hour. The max that we've seen today was a 4 inch per hour report. So a light, fluffy snow that can really stack up pretty quickly. So here are some of your reports. You've been sending them in all day. We always appreciate that. East Bridgewater, near 10 inches of snow. Pocasset's at 8, 5 in Danvers. Nashua, New Hampshire at 1.5 inches on the drier side of the storm system. In Plymouth, we're now at a foot of snow. Oak Bluffs is up to 11, as is New Bedford. Wellfleet at 8.5, and Yarmouth-Porth is up to 8 inches of snow. So we'll track this east tonight. Stays very cold outside. In a couple of hours, we're going to be looking at those snow rates really dropping off. And then by 11 o'clock, most of the steady snow is just on the south shore in the Cape. We're all looking at just snow showers on Cape Cod by tomorrow morning. So no change to the snow forecast. 8 to 14 inches. That includes Boston, the immediate north shore, southeast Mass. And then here's your jackpot zone in purple. We'll see 14 to as high as 18 inches of total snow. We want to go out live to Scituate. That's where Pamela Gardner is this evening. And Pamela, you are right in the meat and potatoes, the heaviest snow band on the map. What's it like there on the South Shore?
Oh, it's great. It's New England weather out here, Eric. What can I say? This is a good old-fashioned nor'easter. And the wind has been whipping around for the last several hours all afternoon. We still have plenty more punch to the storm, too. So keep that in mind. Now it's going to get very icy on the roads. And road crews have done a great job plowing across Scituate. The problem is the blowing and drifting with these very strong wind gusts coming right off the ocean. And that's leading to some of those ocean-enhanced bands. Now, one other thing, all right, we talk nor'easter, especially in Scituate, and the concern flies around here that are we going to see flooding? That's not the case with this storm. We're actually approaching high tide in about 20 minutes or so, and this is the same location that flooded during the king tide a couple months ago, but astronomically low tides are predicted for later today, which is some good news for the residents along here. Eric?
All right, Pamela, thanks for the report, and skip back somewhere warm. We'll check in back with Pam in a little bit. She'll be down there for the rest of the evening as well. And we take a look at some of these snow totals. Very impressive, but the wind's not reaching the damaging point. Right now we're looking at winds about 30 to 40 miles per hour. Our strongest winds will be on Nantucket. And I'm not expecting any widespread power outages or, as Pamela was talking about, any coastal flooding. But that wind blowing around a very dry, powdery snow. So whiteout conditions at times, visibility under a quarter mile. Just take it very easy if you have to go out at any point tonight. We'll have a look at what follows this storm the second half of the weekend and a huge pattern shift for next week coming up in just a little while. Ken?
All right, Eric, thanks. We'll check in with you then. And as you just mentioned, the South Shore getting pounded right now.
Jim Smith continues our live team coverage. He is in Plymouth, which might wind up with the jackpot, just like Pamela's in Scituate.
Yes, Katie and Ken, we might end up as the jackpot location. Conditions, in fact, seem to be getting worse by the minute here at Plymouth Harbor. High winds blowing the snow sideways right into my face as this storm really kicks up. So, as you can see, some folks actually like this kind of weather. As far as I'm concerned, I like this place, say, right around mid-July. That's my preference. Plymouth not alone tonight, though. Cape Cod is also getting shellacked, and that's where we find my colleague, Shantae Land. Shantae?
Thanks, Jim. You can definitely see blizzard-like conditions out here by the strong wind gusts and the way that the snow is pelting me in the face. We're here in Sandwich near Town Neck Beach. We're also at a U.S. Coast Guard base. You can see the wind blowing that boat in the background. But I want you to take a look at this video. On our drive up here from Boston, my photographer and I, Jason, were able to capture some of the conditions. Very, very poor visibility on the roads. And the wind gusts were also strong along the way. We saw one person, just one, walking out there. He said he was going to the store. Take a listen to what he had to say.
I'm fine with it, yeah. I'm not a skier or anything, but I don't mind it.
And blizzard-like conditions. Again, don't bother you. Don't stop you from going to the store.
No, they're not too bad right now.
And again, that was the only person that we saw. Very few cars on the road out this way on the Cape. Live in Sandwich on Cape Shanty Lands, WBZ News.
All right, Shante, thanks very much. Let's move on to Connecticut, where they had a multi-car pileup on the interstate there. It was on Interstate 91 near Middletown. Heavy snow, strong winds played a role in that chain reaction crash. Fortunately, there were no serious injuries. But the storm is even wreaking havoc further down south. Parts of Virginia saw as much as a foot of snow between last night and early today. And behind it, those folks are seeing frigid temperatures down in the teens and single digits. The storm has caused hazardous driving that way as well, a combination of snow and freezing rain. Police in the Carolinas responded to hundreds of accidents despite urging people to stay off the roads.
And airport crews in Atlanta are working to get back on schedule there after the storm. As you can imagine, they are not used to a lot of snow down there. Crews did their best to stay ahead of the snow, but hundreds of flights were delayed or canceled to and from Atlanta. Hartsfield-Jackson in Atlanta is the busiest airport in the United States. A lot of flights have to go through there. And of course, stay on top of this storm and any others with the CBS Boston weather app. You can get live radar, up-to-the-minute temperatures, and check out the weather blog. It's free in the Apple App Store and on Google Play. Well, Boston might well be in the neighborhood of 10 inches by the time this is all done. 200 flights have been canceled at our Logan Airport. 40 more are delayed.
So with that in mind, let's go ahead and check in with Paul Burton. He joins us live now from Copley Square. Paul?
I can tell you the snow is coming down at a pretty good clip here at Copley Square. I'm at the corner of Dartmouth and Boylston Street. The snow is covered here. It makes for a very slick travel. But I can tell you, folks here in Boston, they seem to be enjoying this first winter storm of 2017. But it's that light, fluffy snow, which makes it not too bad to be in. I can tell you, there are a lot of people out here on Boylston Street. They're out here shopping, eating, and just having a great time in this winter wonderland. Reporting live at Copley Square, I'm Paul Burton, WBZ News. Back to you guys.
All right, Paul, thanks a lot. Well, still to come on the program, investigators trying to understand the gunman's motive in yesterday's killings at Fort Lauderdale Airport.
Coming up, the new information we have learned about the shooter. Pictures from Plymouth with the snow coming down at a good clip, and of course the wind really picking up there. We have a few more hours to go of snowfall. We'll have much more on the storm in just a couple of minutes. But first, we want to touch base on some of the other big news of the day. The latest on the airport shooting in Fort Lauderdale yesterday that killed five people.
Police are still trying to identify a motive from the Army veteran who once complained the government was trying to control his mind. The airport reopened this morning for the first time since the attack. There were huge crowds after all flights in and out were canceled yesterday. The suspect, Esteban Santiago, is said to be cooperating with police.
The interview went over several hours and concluded sometime this morning. Indications are that he came here to carry out this horrific attack. We have not identified any triggers that would have caused this attack.
Now, relatives say Santiago was receiving psychological treatment in Alaska. His aunt says that after he returned from Iraq, it was, quote, like he had lost his mind.
Yarmouth police arrested a 16-year-old for murder. Police were called to the Beach in Town Motel on Route 28 last night. They say the teen stabbed to death a family member named James Dean, who's 43 years old. The teen is being held at a juvenile detention facility as he waits for his arraignment.
All right, it is light and fluffy most everywhere, but it is a storm nonetheless, and lots of amounts piling up, especially down on the Cape.
And a lot of people staying inside and wise to do so. Eric Fisher has everything you need to know for what's up next.
Yeah, we thank those who are hanging out with us tonight and catching up with the storm and some of your headlines around the area, and our weather watchers for sending in their reports, which helps us figure out exactly what's going on in each town. So let's take a look at some of those snow totals. A lot of teens out there with that cold air, that light and fluffy snow that we were talking about across the region has really been the story. We've got 5 inches of snow in Redding, Lexington up to 4 inches of snowfall, about a half foot in Mendon, Frankenstoneham at 5 inches, and those are some of the totals a little bit closer into Boston, the biggest totals in southeastern Massachusetts. And the visibility, a story this evening, many trying to get out, do some traveling, run your weekend errands, and low visibility because of that blowing and drifting snowfall. Now, one thing I'm not seeing a lot of is visibility below a quarter mile for a consistent stretch. It's in bands, but it hasn't been persistent, and for that reason, I don't think a blizzard, a technical blizzard, is going to verify. We'll see. The National Weather Service looks into that after the storms. Our storm right now is tracking off toward the north and east. It's pretty far offshore, which is why it's kind of a coastal hugger and bringing the heaviest snowfall across southeastern Mass, Rhode Island, and the coast of Connecticut down toward Long Island. So here's a look at our live Doppler radar, and this is all light snowfall into southern New Hampshire, around the Fitchburg area and that Route 2 corridor, and out toward western Mass. Our really heavy snow, steadiest snowfall around Boston and on the South Shore. So Scituate reaching back into Brockton, Bridgewater. This is where you have your heavier rates. Plymouth has been seeing those as well. And this is where we can really stack up some snow. We want to check in with Pamela Gardner again. She is in Scituate, has been seeing some of the worst of it there, and getting dark, getting snowy, and looks very windy down there on the coast, Pamela.
Oh yeah, it sure is, Eric, and this is where we said it would be worse with the winds across Massachusetts, right along the coast. You have nothing blocking the wind coming from this storm, and it is coming from the northeast, and it's very, very just windy here, cold too, bitter wind chill temperatures, but blowing and drifting snow is going to be an issue, along with visibility, but all these snowplow trucks have been lined up, and I'll tell you, Scituate has been doing a great job of keeping the roads clear. Fortunately, that wind's going to blow it all back across it, so you don't want to head out tonight if you don't have to. Now, we're right here across, right along Scituate Harbor, and this was the area that actually flooded during king tides. Well, we're not anticipating coastal issues and no flood advisories, nothing like that for this particular storm, which is a big sigh of relief. Last time Scituate had a blizzard was actually February 8th of last year, and this whole area was underwater. Not the case this time. We're all happy about that, Eric.
Yeah, Pamela, it's good to have one less thing to worry about with a storm. Stay warm out there and get back into the mobile weather lab, and we'll check back in with Pamela at the 8 o'clock news on MyTV 38. The reason why they're getting battered there toward the South Shore and all the way back toward Buzzards Bay, we've got this little zone of convergence where air is coming together. It's out of the north-northwest on one side. It's out of the northeast on the other. Where that air comes together, it has nowhere to go but up. And that's where you get your heavier snowfall rates. And that's where we expect those more jackpot totals. 14 to maybe as high as 18 inches of snow. Those will be our biggest amounts anywhere from about there in Scituate down toward Cape Cod. But many seeing 8 to 14, 4 to 8, Worcester heading up toward the Newburyport area. Then it drops off very quickly north and west of that line, more festive than anything else. So here's a look at our snow tracking. And I think by about 8:30, 9 o'clock, the snow rates are really starting to come down. We'll be focused more from coastal Plymouth County toward the Cape, and that's where most of the snow will be overnight. Pamela was mentioning the fact that it's so cold, the blowing and drifting snow. For all the plow operators out there who are trying to keep up, that's going to be the issue tonight, that powdery snow flowing back into the roads. So look toward tomorrow morning, still some lingering snow showers on the Outer Cape and Nantucket, and temperatures will be quite cold outside. The winds are strong but not damaging. We're not looking at these 60, 70 mile per hour winds sometimes that you see in a nor'easter. We're looking at 30 to 50 mile per hour winds. They'll be strongest this evening. They're already starting to weaken by midnight. And they're turning northwesterly offshore, another reason why we don't expect any coastal flooding out there from this particular event. So tonight's, it's upper single digits. The snow tapers off, but it will be frigid outside. When you factor in the wind, it'll be feeling like about zero overnight and into early tomorrow morning. So if you have to go out and clean off some of the snow, definitely want to bundle up throughout the day on Sunday. Because even though we get some sunshine, it'll be blustery, a chance for some afternoon snow showers. High temperatures tomorrow are only near 20 degrees. So looking at 21 in Boston, 16 in Worcester for a high, 17 in Fitchburg for tomorrow. Then we look toward Monday, another very cold day. But Tuesday starts a warming process, and although we might get a little thump of snow heading into Tuesday evening, we're looking at a big warm-up by Wednesday. So a little snow changes over to rain, and then on Wednesday we hit 50 degrees. We've got more rain showers on Thursday in the 40s. We're back in the 50s again on Friday with rain, so a lot of what we're getting tonight is going to be disappearing by the end of this upcoming week. Ken, Katie, back to you.
Right, enjoy it while it's here. Thanks, Eric. And let's take you to Plymouth now for a look at what is going on by the harbor as the winds, as you saw Jim and Pamela, the winds have picked up in the area and the snow still coming down.
In the meantime, Danny Roach waiting in the on-deck circle. He'll have your sports next.
Well, good evening, everyone. The Patriots are off this wild card weekend after earning a first-round bye, but imagine if they were in action tonight. You would have Snow Bowl 2 down in Foxborough instead. We'll wait to see if Oakland, Houston, or Miami will be coming to town next week. Meanwhile, offensive coordinator Josh McDaniels interviewing for head coaching jobs today. The 49ers confirming today that they are interviewing McDaniels this evening, while ESPN's Adam Schefter reports Josh interviewing with Jacksonville and the LA Rams today as well. McDaniels was the head coach of Denver in 2009 and 10, then returned for his second stint as Pat's offensive coordinator in 2012. Defensive coordinator Matt Patricia, also a wanted man. According to Schefter, Patricia is interviewing for the head coaching jobs with the San Diego Chargers and the LA Rams today. The 42-year-old Patricia has been with the Pats since 2004, defensive coordinator since 2012. Who will the Pats play? Well, the AFC wildcard game is at the half, and the Texans rolling over the Raiders 20-7. Pats will play the winner of this game next week unless the Dolphins upset the Steelers tomorrow. Then Miami would come to town. Now, no Pats game tomorrow, but WBZ will bring you Patriots game day at 11:30. Dolphins and Steelers kick off at 1 o'clock here on BZ, and we'll preview the Patriots' divisional round opponent on Sports Final at 11:35. Well, both the Bruins and Celtics are in action tonight. The Bees in Florida to face the Panthers, while the Celts will host the Pelicans at the Garden. Avery Bradley will miss the game with a strained Achilles. To college hoops, BC at number 8, Duke Blue Devils' first game without Coach K, who's undergoing back surgery. Former Blue Devil and assistant coach Jeff Capel at the interim helm. Now, the Blue Devils dominated the first half, including five threes. Duke spread the ball around all game as six players reached double digits in the contest. Now, Duke's defense was stifling as well. They got the Eagles to commit 17 turnovers before halftime. However, BC would not go away in the second half, bringing the game all the way to within 8 with 4 minutes left, but too much Duke. Jerome Robinson at a team-high 21 as the Eagles lose 93-82 and fall to 8-8, 1-2 in the ACC. And UMass fell to VCU today, 81-64. So there you go.
Three interviews for McDaniels, huh?
Yeah, I think he's going to end up taking the job. I think he's ready for that second time around.
Yeah. All right. Danny, thanks. Well, we are in the midst of our first winter storm of the new year. That's a live picture from Scituate you're looking at right there.
And we'll have an update on the forecast when we come back. Well, you know by now we are getting lots of snow. So, Eric Fisher, how much more are we expected to get?
We've got about 3 more hours to go where we have the steadiest stuff, and then it begins to taper off. So, Boston, close to 10 inches of snow. Cape Cod, many towns over a foot. South Shore, many towns over a foot of snow. And then once you head up to the 495 corridor north and west, there's snow out there to deal with for sure if you're traveling tonight, but much lighter, and those totals will be much lower. The focus, South Shore, down toward the South Coast, and the Cape for the next few.
So really, if you love snow, the Cape is where you should be right now.
The Cape, up toward Plymouth County, even into New Bedford, where they're getting close to a foot of snowfall, and seems like the new snow capital. Like 3 of the last 4 years, Cape Cod has been where it's at.
So maybe cross-country skis instead of downhill skis.
Do it now, because we've got rain 50s in the forecast this week, so we'll only have it around for a few days.
All right, thanks so much, and thanks for watching, everyone.
The CBS Weekend News is coming up next. Hope to see you back here tonight at 11 o'clock.